I bought a sword. Like most of us, I am in great anticipation of the upcoming final season of Game of Thrones. I've actually just started re-watching the Game of Thrones series, and it inspired me to buy a sword. So I already have a Jon Snow costume, and I've had this idea that I've been toying with for a little while now that I want to complete, and that is a series of VFX death tutorials. And I want the first one to be a Game of Thrones style beheading. So I decided to buy the sword, and I made it happen. Viewer discretion is advised. It might be a little bit gory, though the death is only a split second, but enjoy.
Winter is coming. I, Skyler of the House Stark, hereby sentence you to die.
Tell my family I'm sorry.
Not bad for a thrift store costume, huh? Everything's from a thrift store except for this thing, which is from Target. You can get for like 30 bucks. It's a blanket, I think. It's great. So yeah, this is gonna be a tutorial that I'm gonna put up in the next couple days. I just haven't filmed the tutorial part of it yet, but wanted to give you a teaser as to what's to come, but I'll be on the lookout for a tutorial in the next couple days. Also, which is really cool, is BenQ, which is a company that does like different speakers and things like that, reached out to me and said, we like your channel and we'd like to send you a Bluetooth speaker if you do a review, which is super cool. And it's something that hasn't happened for my channel yet, something I'd like to have happen more often. So I was very psyched to get that speaker, and I'm doing a fair and honest review on that, so check it out. All right, what I have is the BenQ Trevolo S Bluetooth speaker. It retails at $199 from their website. They also gave me a couple Amazon links where it says the product is currently unavailable. We'll see if it's still unavailable by the time you watch this. So what I'm comparing this particular speaker against is my current Bluetooth speaker, which is the Hypergear Beast XL. Solid Bluetooth speaker, does its job. What I'm going to do right now to keep this brief and fun is to just give you my highs and lows from listening to this for the last week. Good number one. It's well constructed, it folds up, and it, you know, doesn't take up a lot of space, but these two wings right here actually project sound as well. And you know, it's just a really nice kind of high quality material. Not a lot of plastic, you can tell it's well made. The battery life is awesome on this. I charged this when I first got it over a week ago, and I haven't had to charge it since. And according to the three indicator lights, green being well charged, yellow being mid charged, red being low charged, it's still on green. So solid on battery life. Gotta love that, because I always forget to charge things. Comparing the sound between these two, this speaker has a really nice, clear, distinct sound. There's very minimal distortion. It just sounds really nice, and it's really good in those mid to high ranges. So it's good for like classical music. It sounds great with vocals. I've been listening to, I've been watching movies using this as the speaker, which sounds really nice. And you know, it's good for kind of like atmospheric sounds, things like that. Where it lacks compared to the other speaker is bassy qualities. You're not gonna wanna listen to, you know, really bassy music with this, unless you can put this up against the wall, because it actually projects sounds going backwards. So if you can get this up against the wall, you're gonna get a lot more amplification and it sounds a lot better that way. But if you have this, say, in the middle of the room, you're not gonna get as much bassy quality. So just something to think about when you're checking out this kind of speaker. And potential drawback as well is it's not very life-proof. It doesn't have the waterproofing that you get out of a lot of Bluetooth speakers, the shockproofing, as opposed to this guy, which you can like set in a pool and it just floats around with you and all that. BenQ, thanks for sending this to me. Definitely am enjoying listening to everything on this. So thanks again. Cheers. All right, guys, thanks for sticking it out with me, even though I know I haven't been posting as much lately. This video is really just a way for me to say, hey, I've got more stuff coming. Sometimes, you know, life just gets busy, but I do plan on making more fun, cool content. Just remember, winter's coming. All right, see you guys later. Peace.